What's up, everyone? NeoCypher here, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution. And it's time for the next duel, which is titled Fighting for Fun, which can maybe describe a few duels in the series so far. A couple are kind of, eh. Well, we might as well just get into it and see how it goes. Yep, that's the story. Alright, so Sora's got 12 in the extra deck. Holy pendulum monster, Batman! Really? All three odd eyes in my opening hand, essentially. Holy jeez. Okay, what is this, dude? This may not last very long at all. Can I get a one turn OTK here? Is cards in the graveyard, please? Okay. Here's the thing. Discard one card, add two Magician Pendulum monsters with different names from my deck to my hand. Also, until the end of my opponent's next turn, this card resolves. Magician cards and Pendulum zones cannot be destroyed by card effects. Okay, I might actually be able to pull off an OTK. Why did he just normal summon that? I'm gonna see if I can pull this off. So, Pendulum Call. Get rid of Performing Power, Revival, whatever it is. I need both of these guys. Oh, wait, these are two different ones. Oh, geez. I just realized these are two completely different. I don't have Timegazer and Stargazer. Okay, let me make sure these are correct. I want to make sure of what these are real quick here. Once per turn, you can target one face of Xyz monster you control this turn. You can use it as an Xyz material from Xyz summon using its rank as if it were a level. Once per turn, you can target one face of Xyz monster you control. I have one level 5 or higher monster control. Okay. I actually have Xyz in here? I do, and I'm probably not even going to need them. Oh, except that's only a 7. Crap. Shh. Yeah, because I don't have the normal magicians I normally do. Oh, crap. This isn't going to work as well as I thought. Because that eyes is a 4. Cool, that's a 3. Oh, no, 3 and 8? Oh, no, this will still work. Never mind. I'm looking at its normal level, not its pendulum scale. So, basically, I need you... in 3. Why can't I pendulum summon? Why is that 4? Oh. Okay, well then let's normal summon you. Ugh, crap. No, I screwed up. I didn't see that bottom where it says if I control more monsters than my opponents. Oh, shoot. Crap, I misread that. I didn't even see that line. So I'm not completely out of this yet. Yeah, because I... Of all the duels, did not have Timegazer and Stargazer. Good news is now I can Pendulum Summon everything I own. Okay, so let me see what I got to deal with here.
Dark Guardian fill up the number of fusion materials and so destroy them. All frightful monsters you control gain an attack for each fluffle monster and frightful monster you control.
Gains how much?
300.
All fright fur monsters, so this doesn't. Okay, so let's do this then. Now, I can Pendulum Summon. I completely didn't even see the line that says if I control more monsters than my, or more cards than my opponent. Yeah.
I'm not going to put you in attack.
Yeah, I did not even pay attention to the fact that, of that ability. I'm used to having Timegazer and Stargazer in my deck.
So now, so what can I fusion, or what can I, do I have a 7 I think sees?
Ooh, Odd Eyes Rebellion Dragon, yeah. Now I actually want to look at this.
You can Pendulum Summon level 7. You can Pendulum Summon this face-up monster in your extra deck. If you can Pendulum Summon level 7, you can Pendulum Summon this face-up card in your extra deck. If the card succeeds somebody using succeeds monster material, destroys the main level 7 lower monster your opponent controls, possible inflict 1,000 damage to your opponent for each card destroyed. And if you do, this card can make 3 attacks during each battle phase this turn. If the card's in your monster zone, it's worked by battle or card effect.
Okay, this is even better. If you can Pendulum Summon level 7, you can Pendulum Summon. If this card is Exceed Summoned, you by using... Oh, I don't have an Exceed Monster's material. Yet. I think I can still win this. We're going to do something stupid here, but I think I can win this still. So attack. Okay, that's still fine.
I need that anyway, so let me see this. When I face a monster control, this card's attack becomes equal to that monster's current attack.
I just want to make sure there's no catches here. My opponent takes no battle damage from attacks involving this card. Once per turn, I can target one of the face-up monster I control. That card's attack becomes equal to the current monster's attack. Okay.
So basically, Zach's not going to be able to do any damage.
So basically, let's do this. Activate the effect. That's gonna matter which one. Go to battle. You are gonna bump that thing out. I need you to take down this. If that's smart, I would have done flop that first. So basically that's twice now my plans have kind of goofed. That's fine. Oh god, what's in here? Just nothing for Monster Reborn. Oh, I forgot about this. Yes. Once per turn, I can target one face of Xyz monster I control. This turn, I can use it as an Xyz material for an Xyz summon using its rank as if it were a level. Because now, I can do this. And this can now attack three straight times. Let's do this. Yeah, no cards in hand, no card on the field. I probably could have done the last turn if I thought about it, because I completely forgot about the bottom left magician's ability. So that could have probably ended like a turn ago. And remember, this is why you need to fully read your cards and what they do. Because with this game, that has always been my biggest issue. Then again, once you get this far into the game, actually probably even maybe as early as 5Ds, if not definitely Zexal, all the texts on all these cards do make it difficult to remember if you don't play them on a regular basis. I mean, Magic the Gathering has some complicated card effects, but some of them I do remember from memory because I constantly play them. Then again, when I play Magic, I'm typically using the same decks over and over to where I've played them multiple times, and I can rattle off some of the card effects. I don't know if you hear my finger snap. Like that. Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a lot different. A lot of these cards I'm seeing for the very first time. That's also why a lot of the time I just will take my time reading the cards, sometimes more than once, because I will forget quickly what they do. I will say though that when it comes to any major faults of this game, I really wish you had the opportunity to, I know you can choose a story deck, or your custom deck. But if you chose the story deck, I wish you had the opportunity to look at the deck first. Also, I wonder if it's like a Slifer Force and a Raw Force. Also, this is like the second straight series now where we are attacking different dimensions. So we've unlocked the next campaign, Duel Cityscape. The reverse duel for fighting for fun. The deck recipe for Fright for Fury. The challenge deck, the Frightful Fluffle. Fright for Sabretooth, Fluffle Dog, Fright for March, and 1679 victory duel points. 100 points for the win, 12 for number of turns, 10 for comeback, 6 for spells, 15 for no traps, 8 for exceeds, 3 for pendulum, 6 for controlling a monster with high attack, 12 for maximum damage inflicted, and 10 for placing 3 of the same card on the field. I don't know if I've ever done that before. Thank you, Allies Pendulum Dragon, you get that? That duel in general went from, oh my god, I've got a turn 1 OTK, to, of course they don't put the Timegazer and Stargazer Magicians in my deck this time, to, I've still got an OTK, to, my god, I misread one of my cards. Yeah. And then again, this could have been over with a turn sooner, had I fully read the effect of another one of my Magicians, the one that let me use an Xyz monster as Xyz material using its rank as a level. So yeah, this was just all sorts of ups and downs, and thankfully it ended on up. Like, the downs were like little teeny tiny slight dips in the road, and I don't know where I'm really going with this metaphor. Anyways, that's all I've got for this video. I hope you folks are enjoying the project so far. I thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.